It is estimated in sub-Saharan Africa that 50 to 90% of babies born with sickle cell disease die by 5 years of age. Screening the babies for sickle cell disease is now the most important public health activity we can do. 80% of babies born in the world with sickle cell disease are born in sub-Saharan Africa. Now we have treatments that not only can prolong life, they actually make the disease expression milder so that these children don't need to die and they also don't need to suffer. This young man, Caleb, who's now 11 years old, was otherwise a typical sickle cell patient will get from time to time some pain or fever. And then all of a sudden he develops this stroke, not because of anything different about him, except he has sickle cell disease.
My name is John Jido, and with me it's my son, Caleb Jido. Caleb Jido is 11 years of age. A non-sickle cell disease patient with repeated strokes and multiple convulsions. The strokes keep repeating or recurring with interrupted convulsions. So we're always going in and out of hospital. I've lost everything in life. Even the mother, the woman who bore Caleb, had to leave, because things were not going the way she had hoped. But I've stood my ground, and I promised to hold his hand even as he goes through this condition, which he does not understand. Caleb's needs are numerous. He's not able to do anything. He cannot walk, he cannot feed, he cannot do anything for himself. I am his hand, I am his head, I am his legs, I am his everything. And I promise to do so till life is end and after.
When the sickle cell hemoglobin gives up this oxygen to the tissues, which is also what hemoglobin is supposed to do, it begins to deform. And then they become also very sticky. And the body reacts as if there's a cut through the blood vessel. So many, many other cells come there to try to, as if to stop bleeding. And with all those cells clogging up the vessel, there's no more blood flow. I met the young woman that I eventually married. We got married in 1970. When our son was born in May 1972, 3 days after he was born, we knew that he had sickle cell disease. And we were just lucky to be at Yale at that time, because the only doctor in America who had started testing babies for sickle cell disease at birth was at Yale, a doctor for my son. That was never something I wanted to be. But in 1974, Yale University required for medical students to get your degree, you had to do some research. So I went back to Kumasi to do my research. And it was my mother, who is very religious, who said that this is your mission in life, is to do something for these children. And I think between myself and my wife, Janet, we sort of decided to go two ways. She said, well, you will learn everything you can about this disease. I will just be his mother. I think his childhood was generally okay. He was very interested in tech, and he went to college. And then, you know, he found a young woman that he liked. They got together, grew up together, got two children, two beautiful children who are, you know, pride and joy at the moment. He was sick for 2 days. I never expected that he was that ill. The day he died, I was with him. I actually spent the night, left him, because I had to go to work early. So when I was leaving him that morning, I knew he was in pain, but I really didn't think that there was anything serious. I spoke to him about 1:30 and said, yeah, the pain was there, but he was otherwise doing okay. About 2 hours later, my wife called me and said something has happened to him, and they tried to resuscitate him and they couldn't. And that was really a shock to me, that something could have happened so suddenly. But I'm almost sure I know what it is, although they didn't, the autopsy they did really didn't look for it carefully, but I'm almost sure that it was like a blood clot into his lungs. If we could get all the children with sickle cell disease to go through a similar life, I would consider that we've done, you know, pretty well with them. We would like to screen every baby in the country for sickle cell disease. But you have to have a place for the baby to go for care before you start screening. When we started that project, Newborn Screening Project, the country had only one sickle cell center at Kolebu. We used the newborn screening program to start the second one in Kumasi. Now we have 18 that are active. And so our friends Novartis, they want to help us open a sickle cell center of excellence at each of the regional capitals. So those will become the focal points of sickle cell care. And one of the things that became very clear to us is that managing the data around newborn screening was difficult. So we approached Novartis and said that we would really think that it would be very helpful if we could develop an app for newborn screening management. It's been a boon. The nurses love having a mobile phone that has the app in it. They all do texting to begin with. And so when they're now taking information from the families, they're putting it on the app. The laboratory receive on their phones names, birthdays, locations of the children that have been tested. When they finish their work, they just call up each child and they put the results in. When they sync it, it goes back to the nurses where they are, you know, 180 kilometers away, and they're able to begin the tracking. So it shortens the time that the nurses have to find the baby. There's an old drug called hydroxyurea. In addition to being a treatment for certain types of leukemia and other blood diseases, it helps to make sickle cell blood healthier. And those who take it daily have fewer complications. They don't get the pain as frequently as the others, or they, when they get the pain, it's not as severe. We have children on hydroxyurea who have gone for 5 or 6 years, have never come to the hospital in pain before, and they're forgetting what sickle cell disease is about. That is very needed here in Africa.
What we are trying to do is to make hydroxyurea accessible to everybody. Once we establish all the centers of excellence in Ghana, and then Novartis is prepared to move into the other African countries, and we shall be an example.
What we have learned from newborn screening for the interventions that we do is that these patients then grow up to become useful people. They're not dependent.
Once every region has a center of excellence where you can do screening, and when you do the screening, you know where to go. I think we shall reach where we want to go.